Got yourself tied up in a knot, the night is cold,
but the music's hot, so come,
cuddle closer,
don't you dare to answer no, sir, put your banker, clerk, and grocer,
let yourself go,
whoa,
let yourself go,
let yourself go.
Lovely stuff, Alex Menon there, and who will be performing tomorrow night in the Capitol. Lovely
yes,
to see you.
Lovely to be here.
Often when we talk about musical inspiration, it's kind of what your parents were into. Where did it come to for you? Where did this sound come from?
I really don't know. I played saxophone as a kid,
yeah.
And I really wanted to listen and get into something totally different from anyone else. I was always a bit of a weird child, so I just discovered this music from the 20s and 30s and decided to run with it.
Yeah, the sax certainly kind of takes you to that swing jazz era, doesn't it? You know, when you're probably learning that repertoire as a youngster, you're probably thinking, I could see where this could go. You know, you have formed what is, you know, a whole orchestra
yes.
from it.
Yeah.
Can't be easy to find chaps of a certain like and ladies who are all kind of into that same thing at this in this generation.
Yeah, it was a difficult thing finding the right guys, but we've been together a long time now, and I've made the guys tapes and CDs and really got them to listen to stuff and hone their, you know, their love of this music, and they do such a fantastic job with it. I wanted not just an orchestra to play the music, but it also had to look the part as well, because when I was going to watch bands that do this kind of stuff, it never quite clicked. So I wanted it to be like this immersive experience where everyone could see the costumes, listen to the music, and feel like you're going into a different world, really.
Yeah, I mean, where do you learn that from? Because there is a sense of style here which has in some ways been lost. We don't see kind
yeah.
of that big swing band feel like this anymore. It's certainly not dressed like this.
Yes.
What did you watch to get into it?
All the great films, you know, Fred Astaire, Ginger Rogers, all those
yeah.
black and white classics. And it's just like this whole, feeling of quality. Everything, you know, from the songwriting to the look of the thing, everything was such a high quality. And I thought, you know, where's this gone? I need to try and recreate this if I can. So
yeah.
that started the whole story.
I'm making an assumption here in terms of the audience. Are they of a certain generation, or actually are you bringing a new audience to this type of music?
You'd be really surprised. I mean, I thought that, most of the people that would remember this stuff from its first inception have gone.
Mm.
So we're giving this fresh to people, and there's a hunger for it because of films like Downton Abbey and Boardwalk Empire series and all that kind of stuff. People want to go out and experience it and, you know, see what it's all about. So it's
yeah.
a younger generation as well.
Really interesting, the fashions and the trends come around, don't they? Next year, a huge year for the 1920s.
Yes.
It's the centenary, and you'll be reflecting that with this gig tomorrow night, won't you, in terms of the music you'll be delivering?
Yes, so we've got a really nice gig tomorrow, and it's pretty much sold out, but we're going to be focusing a lot this coming year on the music of the 20s, because, as you say, centennial, and it's going to be really great to get the guys looking at that style of music, but it's really punchy, and it was, you know, prohibition in America, and things were edgier than what people give them credit for today. So it's like the rock and roll of its time, really. It was innovative.
Yeah. Alex, we'll chat more in a moment. First, we'll bring in another clip. This is the Dunlop Sisters, who will be joining you tomorrow night.
In days a glimpse of stocking was looked on as something shocking, now heaven knows anything goes. The authors to who once knew better words now only use for letter words, writing prose. Anything goes.
So the Dunlop Sisters, I just basically stumbled across them. They was doing an open mic night, Christmas time, and they were doing Michael Bublé type performances, but they looked so great together and they sounded great together, and I thought, I wonder if I can get them to go back a little bit further and interpret this great music. You know, we heard, you know, Cole Porter's Anything Goes,
yeah.
and a lot of the standards that we play are things that people might not think come from the 30s or the 20s, but they go right back, and a great song, I think, will really stand the test of time. But those two girls are fabulous, and with the hair done and the dresses, they, you know, people are transported back, I think.
It really does take you back to a period that in some ways has been slightly forgotten. Let's talk a quick bit about the record as well, which
yes.
is out, because you will no doubt be doing some of the hits from there as well.
We are, yeah. So our last album, a thing called On With The Show, we decided to look at Hollywood's golden era of composers, people like the Gershwins, bands like Isham Jones and his orchestra, and all those great bands, composers, orchestras. And it was a slightly more lavish production, so we had three violins, we had a full sax section, a full brass section, but we're going to be doing some hits from that album tomorrow night, and it's also available on our website, alexmendham.com.